Croy, I hope you appreciate these, because these are not easy to make. How many times I have to go back and forth making sure something's working.
Hey, Arthur.
What's going on?
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said you knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Hosea wants you to join him instead. Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
All right.
And I'm sorry for being foolish.
Back on the road again.
Oh, hey, Arthur.
Back on the road again. You like my horse? I think since I gave it a mohawk and made it look more distinguished, it makes it super easy to, that's not far at all. Makes it super easy to find it. Am I not allowed to ride my horse over there? Alright, not sure what that was about.
You're alright, boy. Yep.
Oh my goodness, horse. Don't go too far. Too many times we have to run around
to
work.
What are you doing?
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it. They made it. They must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah,
sure.
I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? Then it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses, and all I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past them.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
One can hope.
Here we are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it? Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. Okay. She's at the house.
Why does he just hop on there like he owns the joint? You're gonna be the first to die.
You
heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
What you want?
Found something. Out in the hills, thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it.
Oh,
relax,
shit.
I ain't here to rob you. No, it seems that's easy enough. Why not do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Mm.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it. At least not without orders from...
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Gonna get the town drunk.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
Oh, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have a thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need some.
I ain't playing dress up. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward. Just a bit. Squint.
Oh, perfect.
What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. My broke poor mammy's heart. There. Fenton, there, there. Don't get mad now.
Watch out. Free beer.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so. Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me. Him, don't madden him. He's turned idiot. Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour? Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Let's hand out the liquor.
So we're bartenders now.
name is Melvin. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your lucky day.
I'll have one, Fenton.
A gift. Bounty. It's a sin to look a gift for cinema. But I see a gift for cinema.
Just keep them coming.
What?
Don't be shy, boys. Don't be shy.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Fenton, open another bottle. It's
where
did
mine
live? Now it's your opportunity to get idiots and drunk. Come on.
You're a fine man, Fenton.
We got
fine
one,
man.
My boys. Let's
don't
go.
Listen to your brother.
Providence.
Over here, Fenton.
It's a long 30 minutes.
Drink up, folks, or you'll make Fenton mad.
Oh, wife is gonna kill me. I only went out for milk.
I know Fenton looks mad, but he's enjoying every minute of this, I promise you.
Well, that hit the spot. Keep coming, Fenton.
Drink up, drink! Des
Moines Raiders.
Good evening, gentlemen. Quiet libation.
You.
Me?
You're the bastard who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Joe, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him.
Oh, shit.
It's those bastards from Shane and Bill.
Fuck, I can't see shit.
You think we wouldn't find you?
Come on, get up here.
That's, is there smoke in the bar?
Get off me.
Where's my hat? Where are they? Oh, fuck. Gotta reload. Jesus, annihilated.
Come on, Peyton.
They're in that wagon.
I'm getting this out of here.
Ain't gonna let this go, Arthur.
I don't want this gun.
More coming after us. There's more to your right.
Behind us,
Arthur, coming out of the alley.
We run with it around here.
Get down now.
Ahead of you. Look out on your right.
I want both those sons of bitches dead.
Good. Keep on them, Arthur.
Jesus. Come on.
Made it.
I see it. Think you can steal from us?
If my horse would have given me the right gun, I would have been good on this.
getting us out of here.
Ain't gonna let me. Let's go, are they?
Over there! They got out the back!
Got more.
There's more to your right. I just saw them coming out of the alley. Hit the moonshine.
We run no liquor around here. They don't feel out of our business. Ah! Gonna get you.
God.
Watch your back.
I had my other gun. Bullets can he take?
You're gonna die in alone!
That's him down with.
Look out, boy!
We run the battle out here!
Yeah. You see any more of them?
Don't think so. Over a few bottles of booze?
I reckon it's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay. Pull off the road here.
All right. We're good.
Remind me never to take up a career. What was it?
Advertising.
You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite. See what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch. So, what do you think?
About what?
Fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something. Ain't nobody gonna know we was here. Because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them, or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
Well, how the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side, and then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done it, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback for my daddy.
Payback? I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something.
Now, if you will excuse me, Arthur, I got to write a letter.
On to the next one. Where's my horse?
You all right there?
There it is.
Stay away from me.
But I got a tip.
That's exactly what I'm afraid of.
Oh, it's get away from me.
I'm telling you.
It always is with you. Then we end up hidden in a burning barn getting shot at.
You're a sad man.
Get on the horse.
Mr. Morgan. Sad man indeed.
Gentlemen. Okay, boy.
There we go. It's a nice horse.
We need to talk to you.
God, everyone needs to talk to me.
Yeah.
The screen looks weird. Must have been a raccoon. Ugly. Ooh. Sorry, I'm destroying all your crops. Guy is filthy.
Can I help you there?
You know me.
We're supposed to be my business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe, about some horses.
A fellow with a scar and a Mexican.
Yes, sir.
Out by the stables.
Thank you. Have a wonderful day now.
Everybody and everywhere there's troubles.
And have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family. A family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
That hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
And?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on the boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels. Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prized horses I'm talking about. Them, they'll get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred.
Whoa! I have a feeling I'm gonna end up getting my butt whooped on this.
Braithwaite woman.
Jose and Sean were planning on going over to the Braithwaites. You haven't seen them?
No, not yet. If they're there already, they better keep their heads down. You don't need this to be any more complicated than it already is.
$5,000 for horses. We've been robbing the wrong folk all these years.
Yeah. He doesn't know what he's talking about. But get even a third of that, it'll be worth it.
Jesus, dude.
So how are we gonna play this?
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point.
I'm gonna mess with the brightness. Colorblind mode, that's cool. Like, barely visible, heavily visible. Let's do that. I don't think it really did anything. That's neat. Automatically
themselves. Blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Some horses?
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
A partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay then. Look, head on up to the stables. Someone will come see you.
Tranquilo.
See, look, my damn gun's always disappeared.
Passing you.
On you go.
That's it. Nice and easy. No need to rush. You don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. There, boy.
So the guy literally looks like he's dressed in dog poop.
Alright, I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. Hitch up here.
All right, boy.
Let me do the talking. Hello there.
Can I help you, boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs, looking to do some breedings. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is your boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm.
My guy looks terrible.
Saratoga.
Is that so?
Unofficially.
Of course. Well, this here's Cerberus. Here you go, boy. Cerberus. greaser, huh?
Okay. Bandana's on. Don't need nobody recognizing us.
Can I mug him? Can I have my weapons? No. Oh my goodness.
Quick, come on.
Yeah,
cover
thanks.
Your face. They know you.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two. Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Whoa, whoa.
Easy now.
Whoa, now, easy. Marston, you're gonna tether him up.
Whoa.
Okay. Javier, you're gonna lead the stallions. You're okay. This way. Come on. Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back. If there's any problems, we regroup at Clemens Cove.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
Get going, you two! Up!
Going? Stop! Stop! You're being robbed!
Oh, shit!
Yeah. Let's get these horses to Clemens Cove quick before we run into any more trouble.
Whoa, you okay there, boy?
Shit! One of the stallions is loose! Keep going! I'll get him!
I was like, that one's crazy. A horse feels dragging another horse.
Clemens Cove is just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, that could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone. Hey, hey! You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
What you boys want?
Heard you pay good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
Okay.
John, Arthur, Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you... I'd give you 650 for
them. I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys. But I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellers into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on. Yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believe the yarn spun us by one of that Gray family. Imagine we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
Come on, guy, walk.
Arthur.
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So,
I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to.
Who's Trelawney?
Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
Charles in charge.
Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
You okay, boy? Wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us.
Hold up a second.
Catch up, dude. Jeez.
You were saying before you disappeared on me?
Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that. Soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another.
Reckon it's that one with the fire outside.
Let's take a look.
Shit. This don't look so...
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house.
You see anything there?
Bed's not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess
tracks.
Maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet.
There's some blood here. That ain't good.
What are you doing? Let's go.
I'm leaving, dude. Jesus.
Boy.
They went down the path here. How's your track these days?
All right. I guess.
Well. Lead the way, then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find him.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
Hey, look. They continue on the other side of the truck.
Get that horse. Hey, look. Line, Arthur. Let's go see what those fellas have to say.
What's wrong, Arthur?
This isn't gonna end well.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
strange. Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here!
Come here!
Oh, shit. I'm just gonna beat him up.
You wanna come at me?
You stay there.
Where is Trelawney?
I don't know anything.
Yep, just beat him.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
You do it.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite's place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line. Must be it.
Easy.
Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive?
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Look, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
God dang it. And I don't have my guns like I like.
Who knows what he told them? Let's get after those sons of bitches.
They've gone into the cornfields. We need to flush them out.
Try to whistle for my horse.
Go that way.
All right, got one.
I think there's one over here.
You're mine.
Hey, good. We got one more, Charles.
Do we? Maybe this guy's head soon. I don't know, Troy. Over here.
Hey, I see something on the ground over here.
He's dumped his gear. Look around. You can't have gone far.
Looking, Arthur. You must be close.
Oh, where did he go?
You see anything?
Jesus.
He's mine! Let me take him.
You get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet.
Damn.
Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you.
Of course. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Damn you! The gunshots are coming from that.
Oh, fuck.
That's how you want to do it?
Why can't I never whistle for my damn horse? Arthur.
He should be the last of them.
All right, let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right.
Is that gun no longer in my inventory? Nope. Well, what about the one on my back? Scam.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
Might you wait for me?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp, I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Bounty hunters, Pinkerton's lawmen. Everywhere we go, more and more civilization. Perhaps this is it from now on. We shall see, I guess.
I really need my weapons. Need somewhere to hide. Well, that definitely surprised me.
I'm just some effete buffoon.
What?
A man of words and not of action. Hardly a man at all.
Well, I think you're as slippery as an eel in an oil slick, but still a man.
Because I think I've found something interesting.
Yeah?
Have you ever robbed a stagecoach?
No, never. Well, who would have even thought? Of course I robbed a goddamn stagecoach. You know I have.
And what's the problem with stagecoaches?
The armed man attempting to put a bullet in your head?
Not quite. The odds. I mean, is it worth the robbing?
Sometimes.
I know. But, well, if you'd like to come with me, I can introduce you to a new best friend, and he's going to give you all the decent, robbable stagecoaches a hot-blooded degenerate could require.
Well, I could require a whole lot. Friend of yours.
Rhodes.
Because what can possibly go wrong there?
I was just
well,
there.
Lead the way and we'll find out.
You sure seem to have got about around here.
You know me. I like to make friends in low places.
How the hell you end up down here anyway?
I could ask the same of you. I have a few commitments over this way. Some expenses to meet.
Expenses? What expenses? Gentlemen's canes and rabbits to pull out of hats.
Among other things, I had quite a nice little business going for a while. Shares in a gold mining company. Excellent returns for the investor of a certain financial standing. Until, well, that unfortunate run-in with the law.
Yeah, that's how it goes. Thanks for disappearing on us during that Sean business, by the way.
I'd done my part. Each to their strengths, dear boy. You know, you boys should really watch yourselves with those two families. Here we are. We can hitch up outside. I'll make the introductions, Arthur.
Hello there. Real good, boy.
Go ahead, dude.
Come on. Hang back a bit and let me do the talking. We don't want to scare him off.
Madam?
Some damn Indians saw the lady on her way into
Hello, Josiah. How have you been?
Dandy. And you, friend?
Like I said, times are tough. My missus is a bad woman. Terrible woman.
They often are. But how's work, Alden?
Terrible. Wages got cut again. They reckon they just invented a new horse's carriage will be the end of us.
They've been saying that nonsense since they invented the wheel. The wickedness of bosses.
I know. My comrades here and I are greatly discouraged from the adequate fulfillment of our duty.
A discouraged man is no man at all, Alden. No.
That's not what people at the post office sound like.
My friend Arthur here has a present for you.
Here.
Ain't you kind, sir?
Call him Arthur. He's one of us, a fellow man of distinction.
Okay. Well, this is perfect timing. I think you'll like this one, Josiah. It'll be coming south down the river road through Siltwater Strand.
Thank you, Alden. Thank you very much.
Oh, and Josiah, if you or Arthur are ever out Strawberry Way, ask for my colleague there, a feller called Hector. He's also one of the, what did you call us again?
Discouraged men, Alden.
That's it, discouraged men. I like that.
Well, goodbye, Alden, or should I say, adieu.
Oh, adieu, Josiah.
What the hell was that?
I thought you might like to see that pantomime.
River Road through Siltwater Strand, he said.
Okay. I think I know a good spot to wait. Follow me.
Let's go, boy.
Let's go, boy.
Okay, let's go. This way.
Waiting on you.
What's wrong? Let's go.
All right, let's go.
Yeah! What did I tell you? Simple as can be. Seems a lot of the station workers are in on it these days. Earning a pittance, the unions are whipping them up, so they want something on the side. Like he said, there, Strawberry. Could create a lot of opportunities for a man in your line of work.
I ain't sure about going back to Strawberry after all that market business.
Didn't sound like you left anyone alive to recognize you, so I wouldn't worry too much, dear boy. All this trouble, you gentlemen are becoming quite the celebrities, aren't you? Soon you'll be on the front of a dime novel. And dead, of course.
We're hoping to be long gone before that. Dutch has a plan.
If anything goes wrong, let's meet back here at this crossroad, okay?
All right.
Okay, this should do.
Sure. Here.
I'm hoping we won't need those.
Better safe than sorry. So what were you thinking?
Well, according to this, the loot is located in a strong box, which is in the back. I'll put on a little performance, and you can scurry around, open the strong box, and relieve them of their goodies.
And how do I open the strong box without threatening someone to open it for me?
This should work.
And I can do this silently?
Well, I'm hoping complete silence won't be necessary. But you're going to wish you had your earplugs. This is Damson. Oh, very good, Alden. Very good. Of course, if everything goes wrong, you can wave your guns around like you normally do. Hold tight. They'll be here soon. There it is. Right on time. Let's go. Keep your distance so they don't see you.
And please leave that gun in its holster for once. I'll ride ahead and get the coach to stop. You hang back. Don't let them spot you or you'll scupper the whole thing.
It's a free country.
Did you say a show?
It's a small benefit to build an opera in Blackwater. Just...
Mrs. Chester Danson.
I flatter, buddy.
Stop the coach, my good man! Stop the coach!
Fools who believe Westerners don't know anything about culture.
I couldn't agree more.
Could you? It's such a small show, but would you sing something for me? I'm looking for a mezzo-soprano.
I don't know.
Miss Damson, you owe it to West Elizabeth. I have your card. The event is on the 23rd of this month. I can't say enough about Mrs. Damson. Magnifico. So sorry, gentlemen, for the interruption. Farewell. Well done, sir. Well done.
It was easy. You did all the work.
Teamwork, my dear boy. Teamwork.
Here you go.
Thank you. Oh, it's only good. Go see Alden from time to time. See you soon, Arthur.
This might be end of the last mission for this time around. Can I have my guns back? Come on, horse. Get moving. I just robbed these people. It's not gonna go well.
Hey, fellas, I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough.
You don't recognize me? Whatever.
This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We're just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big. But his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we could take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper, bonds, metal.
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle?
On earth.
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Hop on. I'll fill you in on the way.
No, I'm driving.
Fine.
Is that my horse?
All right, let's get this over with.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of a horse. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his ass. A smug fucker.
Okay. So what she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting, she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook? No, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right fella for tea at the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. There really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still. Tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security after that business at the saloon.
We just robbed their horses, too.
That was you? Jesus.
Yeah. So, we're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry. I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle. We're making a delivery. That's all. Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then.
Yep.
Thank you.
second. You not worried about them greys, English?
Excuse me?
You not worried about them greys?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Maybe you're right.
You know what? Here. I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally and stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
I'm not going to go that far.
We're here. Stay out of sight. I'll do the talking.
Hey, hold him right there.
Yeah.
What you want, boy?
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say?
Yeah. They said you'd understand. Some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there,
okay,
they said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink, Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? Then you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. A bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half of it. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horses like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Huh. Real fancy place as they was, Hamish. Real fancy. Because if some folks got all the money, they can build quite the fanciest places imaginable, eh? Mm. Well, the average man... So okay. You can hold up in here till it gets dark.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. There's plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves. We coat everything in moonshine. And then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained. And that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
They should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was born burning down manor houses.
We'll burn
come quietly.
Quiet. There's someone coming on the left.
Oh, hey. Well, I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
We'll take care of this fella. You douse the fields, I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble.
I'm gonna douse this too.
Think she'll go, Arthur? Light her up.
After you, sir. Yeah. Now let's burn those bloody fields to the ground.
I got the right hand.
Come on. 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 Come on
This is a goddamn mess.
The wagon we saw come in earlier. We can nick the horses from that.
All right, where is it?
This way. Jesus! There's more of them! Stay with me! Shit! More of the bastards!
Not letting me do anything.
Fine, you're on your own then.
Well, I'm. What am I supposed to do?
Damn.
Look out, there's more of them.
Is there a knife in here? It glitched. It wouldn't let me cut a horse loose. It wouldn't let me do anything. That's a really cool level. Shit.
Little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
word with you, Morgan.
Make it quick. Come on, game. Let me run over to him.
What is it?
We got something cooking you might be interested in.
Am I gonna like the sound of this?
Been cooking since Horseshoe, but you went and kicked up all that commotion at Valentine. Now, we was preparing to rob the bank there until you got involved in all that nonsense, and I don't know, I just feel like it's unfinished business.
That wasn't my fault. It was just one of them things.
How come every time I get in trouble, I'm called a fool and an idiot? But when you get in trouble, oh, it's just one of them things.
It's a good point, Arthur.
A very good point.
All right, well, what do y'all want me to do?
Hit the goddamn bank with us.
You really think it's worth going back there?
Four of us can hit the bank easy, but I ain't gonna lie to you. There will be law if we linger.
And if we're serious?
No, just local boys being rounded up and pressed into action.
Meaning?
If we go in quick and quiet, we can hit it just fine. If there's four of us, I mean.
Y'all think it's worth the risk?
It's a bank, Arthur.
So? Is the take good?
According to the fella I met, yes. It's the end of the stock sales. Plenty of money and plenty of people milling about.
All right, I suppose it's worth taking a look at least.
We should wait until the morning. In any case, I need to change out of these rags if I'm gonna be performing.
Okay. So, Bill, this better be worth it.
Oh, it is. We put a lot of research into this one.
I hope so. All right. Let's go.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss?
That man. The debtor, Thomas Downs, apparently he's dead.
Dead? Huh. Well, he didn't seem very well.
His wife. I believe he has a wife and child. She will assume the debt, of course.
Of course.
Then you can head up there and collect. We lent them a lot of money.
Okay.
Gentlemen, let's go rob ourselves a bank.
What's the plan, then?
Oh, well, we're gonna send Karen on in ahead as a distraction. Then we're just gonna rush on in afterwards. Just a small bank in a little town. Nothing that big in way of security. We just need to bring you along as a insurance policy.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Okay, let's move out.
It's gonna be a big one.
Once the shooting starts.
Well, that's reassuring.
Like I said, we'll see how it looks. If we can get in all right, we'll send Miss Jones ahead to the bank. They won't recognize her.
I'll show you boys how it's done.
What are you thinking this time?
I don't know. Fellers always like the lost little girl, but nobody plays a drunken harlot quite like me. Nita should work.
Once she's got them distracted, we'll move in.
When I was scouting the place the other day, there was only a couple of guards.
We deal with them and any customers who are feeling brave. And you always fancy yourself as the vault man, right, Arthur?
Now I see why you brought me.
Hey, I'm more than willing.
Nah, best I do it.
Oh. And did Dutch tell you I've also been cooking up some deals with them gray boys?
What? No. What kind of deals?
See, you don't realize, Morgan. I'm out there putting in the work the same as you. I've been drinking with them a couple times now. Seems they're looking for some extra security.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Could be something in it for us.
Well, just be smart about it. Got a lot of irons in that fire right now.
Yes, I know, Morgan.
Glad you and Lenny are along for this, Karen.
Someone's gotta keep you boys out of trouble. I ain't sure even Lenny can be relied on to keep his head. Not after that night you two had in Valentine.
Yeah, I've been trying to forget that. What little I remember of it.
You've always been a bad drunk. And before you say it, I know. Takes risky.
How about we wait till after the bank, all right? Can't believe you got me going back to Valentine.
Should've never paid off the bounty.
It ain't hurt you leaving that bank behind.
Not really.
Work a town and not hit the bank? That's downright pathetic.
I guess we went a bit beyond working it. We shot the place to hell.
You did, Morgan. Not me. I played it cool up there. Couple of punch-ups, dealt with some O'Driscolls.
Ah, is that right?
Like I said, you mess up, it's just one of them things. I mess up, I'm the prize idiot.
Well, Bill, I don't know what to tell you.
Surprised you ain't already ripped me about that dynamite again. One mistake, and I'll never live it down.
What do you need? A pat on the back? A medal?
Just know, I got the lead on this one.
We'll see about that once things get going. So, thinking this through. You rob Cornwall's train. We shoot a heap of his men in Valentine. We rob his stagecoach.
This is just dawning on you now.
And now, we're going back to the one place he knew where to find us.
That's the genius of it. Folk never look at what's right under their nose.
I ain't sure that's always true.
What's happened to you? You're getting real nervy in your old age.
The last few weeks happened.
Forget about Cornwall. He can't have many men left at this point. Got a bit hairy in that barn, but we all walked away fine from that.
Didn't walk away with much.
I guess where I took the sheep that time.
Four of us could deal with them in Valentine, and four of us could deal with them after the coach robbery. I ain't too worried.
If you say so. We need to move quick once we're in Valentine. I'm sure they ain't forgotten us.
Of course! In and out! Dutch is gonna love this.
Let's get it done first.
Back to where it all started.
Keep it down now. We're here.
Just paid off the bounty.
Good morning.
How do you? Saw the auction. Saw him sloping out of the hotel. First thing I
know. Ain't your first time. Okay. Let's leave the horses here off the main drag.
All right, gentlemen. Here we are.
Okay. Get ready. Go to work.
Of course. All right, keep it cool and follow me, fellas.
So, we never decided. Is it lost little girl you want, or the drunken harlot?
I think I'd like to see the little girl lost.
So even you long to save the fallen women, eh, Arthur?
You break my heart. You really do.
You're ready, get going.
Good luck, gentlemen.
We got this.
I really need my regular guns if this is gonna work.
Okay, we're going.
No, hold on. Wait till she's gotten real down.
I'm a child, and if I don't want to go back to the workhouse.
Get your goddamn hands up! Go. This is a gun! Robbery!
Nobody move! Don't worry about it! Nobody move! Don't make us hurt you! Here, unlock the door.
Unlocked. We're good.
What do you think we're here for? Come on. Open the goddamn vault. Open it. Don't make me hurt you. Too goddamn slow. Slowly! You better get that door open right now.
I'm nearly there.
Too slow. Shut up, bitch! Hurry!
Damn, dude.
Come on!
I'd shoot next to him, but...
Okay.
If I accidentally miss. This seat's playing me.
I'm in. Someone come make sure the chute behaves himself in here.
Come here. Open the lock boxes now.
The manager does that.
God damn it. Now what?
Guess I'll crack them or blow them up. Keep an eye out. I'll be as quick as I can.
Come on.
Yeah, I think I should be able to crack these.
I need to get by this dude. Oh, fuck. I didn't actually have to do it.
As I can. This is slower, but it's quieter.
Okay.
Me too. Boys, you need to move this along!
Hey, watch him there.
Don't worry. I see him.
Please. Let me go. I won't say nothing. I swear.
Shut the hell up and stay where you are.
How's it looking there?
We're doing okay.
Good. Told you.
Don't count your chickens just yet.
Bill, how's it going in there?
We're getting there. A few more minutes.
Getting quicker at this.
I'll go check the front.
That's another one cleared. This is looking good.
How much longer?
Nearly there.
Okay, you reckon that's enough now?
Maybe. It's never enough.
Well, I am ready to get the hell out of here whenever you are.
One more.
Last one.
Good. We gotta move.
Hmm. $5,000. Is he dead? He's dead. Bank teller's gotta have some money on him. I guess not. Really, nothing up here. Let's get out of here.
I think we're fine. Come on, I'll lead the way.
Let's go. Everybody, stay calm.
All of you count to 100 and keep your mouth shut. You understand me?
Adios.
All right. Yeah,
yeah. Of course I'm freaking wanted.
Now let's get the hell out of this goddamn town.
Body shots, bread and butter.
Look out! More of the sons of bitches!
Oh shit. Annihilate that dude.
Come on, get across! Gotta beat that train more.
Come on, go, 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 go!
Stupid and dangerous. Thank you, Bill.
We're alive and we're paid. Yeah. I don't see the problem.
Yeah, and that is the problem. Bill, this is a very good take. Dutch will be happy, even if it did come with a heap of trouble.
Ah, it was fun.
Well, maybe you're right. Now, go on, get out of here. I have some other business to attend to. Don't head directly back to camp and make sure you ain't followed.
I want to go back where I can camp. I'm wanted there again. Where's our camp? God dang.
husband's not cold in the ground and you've come back here. Archie, I nearly paid off what was owed.
Your husband knew the rules when he took that money. Now, I'm real sorry about the way things turned out, but he had a choice. Ain't my fault about the way the world is.
He didn't have a choice. He was good and he did good. There wasn't no choice in that. And you've as good as killed him yourself, and don't kid yourself. You had a choice.
You speak as if killing was something I cared about.
You ever wonder about eternity? You should.
I hope it's hot and terrible, Mrs. Downs. Otherwise, I'll feel I've been sold a false bill of goods. Now, please, give me that money. Either you got a lazy eye or lack of respect. Which is it, boy?
I ain't got no lazy eye. No respect for the likes of you.
Well, maybe when your mother's finished mourning your father, I'll keep her in black, on your behalf. You think on that, boy?
Well, maybe you shall, sir. And maybe other events will transpire.
You best stick to them books, because mark my words on this. Vengeance is an idiot's game. Ah, Mrs. Downs, thank you for your punctuality. It's next to godliness, isn't it?
That's cleanliness.
I'll have to take your word on that. Good day.
Fast travel me back to camp. Fast travel me back to camp. $20,000. Damn, how much money do I got now? All right, Troy. That is that. Let's hope everything worked out well, because it never seems to work out just perfectly right with all this, but that is okay. I think we are at like the 50% done mark with Red Dead. I'm gonna try to finish it. Let's see how that goes. All right, see you, Troy.